all-time bacon crockpot mac and cheese. I've had so many requests lately for comfort food, and I just don't think there's anything as comforting as a nice creamy bowl of mac and cheese, with a little sprinkling of crispy bacon, of course. So let's get started. So first, I already have 2.5 cups of milk and 1 can of evaporated milk in our crockpot. To that, we're going to add 1/2 teaspoon of paprika. I don't know about you, but I think paprika is such an underrated ingredient. I love the smokiness that it gives. Okay, and then 1/2 teaspoon of garlic powder. Okay, give that a little whisk. Perfect. Next up is our pasta. I usually use macaroni, but I have shells today, so that's what we're gonna do. So it's 1 pound, about 4 cups. Give that just a stir. Why not? Why not? Beautiful. All right, now to that, we're gonna add 4 tablespoons of butter. It's 1/2 stick. Okay, so for the cheese, you have to use Velveeta. Don't even argue with me. It is the creamiest mac and cheese you will ever have. Just divine. So let's go ahead and add 8 ounces of Velveeta. And then 1 cup of Cotswold cheddar. Now, I don't actually have Cotswold cheddar, so I'm just using sharp cheddar. Feel free to do the same. Cotswold has some little chive pieces throughout. We're gonna snip some chives in the garden, and we'll stir that through right before. And then for that little bit of saltiness, I absolutely love a little bit of Parmesan cheese in my mac and cheese. Fantastic, just give that a stir. And that is literally it. We're just gonna cover this, let it do its thing for about 2 hours. Now I recommend coming in and giving it a good stir every about 20 to 30 minutes just to make sure it's nice and creamy. If you have kids, have them do it. That'd be super helpful. One less thing, am I right? And then we're gonna crisp up some bacon, and that's it. Basically, that was what, 30 seconds of prep, and the crock pot's doing all the work except for frying the bacon. Okay, well I am just starving and smelling this mac and cheese, so let's see how we did. Ah! Yes, creamy, dreamy mac and cheese. I cannot even wait to curl up and have a big old bowl of this, y'all. So all that's left to do is I'm just gonna add the bacon and the chives, give it a little stir, and that's it. For the whole recipe, visit theroasttable.com, and for more cooking inspiration, visit facebook.com/theroasttable.